Yep.
With Thanksgiving, the hopes they hold for their lives together, and we anticipate the growth of their love for one another, love which is nourished and strengthened by everyday little things, all those creative, special, and unique ways that people who love each other express and demonstrate the reality of the words, I love you. Who gives Marie the young?
I do.
Marriage, ladies and gentlemen, is an honorable estate instituted by God at the very beginning of human history. Since it is divine in its origin, its institution, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, and in a way which is both honoring to its originator and satisfying to its participants. We together invoke God's blessing upon you, asking him to be your captain of matrimony, so that you may continue to find in each other resources to strengthen your marriage, enable you to grow together, and deepen your love for one another in the passing years. Weddings are joyous occasions, and we associate with marriage in our thoughts all the charms of home, and of all that is beautiful and uplifting, most tender and sacred relations of life. The foundation of this God-appointed relationship is unconditional love, freely given, joyously received, love whose character and qualities are expressed so beautifully in 1 Corinthians 13, verses 4 through 8. Love is patient, love is kind, not jealous. Love does not brag, it's not arrogant. Love does not act unbecomingly, it does not seek its own. It's not provoked. Love does not take into account a wrong suffered. Love does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but rejoices with the truth, bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never fails. Now we live by these three faithfully. The greatest of these is love. And I have some questions for you. Shall we do consent to be first? You take Marie, your lawfully wedded wife, do you promise to love her, honor, and cherish her, and to support and assist her through all the labors of life? Do you pledge yourself to be her husband and to be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? If so, answer.
I do.
Love him, cherish him, and to support and assist him through all the labors of life. Do you pledge yourself to be his wife and to be faithful to him as long as you love him? If so,
I do!
Wow.
This is the file that we're holding. The honorable, first and then. I, you, the second.
I, in front of God.
And in the presence of my family and friends.
And in the presence of family and friends.
Thank you, Marie.
From this day on, for better or for worse.
From this day on, better and for worse. For which of all.
Sickness and health.
Sickness and health.
To love and to care.
As we make together.
Joy, life's pleasures.
Joy, life's pleasures.
Life's burdens.
And bear life's burdens.
As long as our lives.
As long as our life endures.
Let it be faithful to my death.
My pledge to be faithful to my death.
Wait, it's your turn.
I stopped shaking at the talk. Can't read the script.
I'm reading the second.
I'm reading the second.
And in the presence of my family and friends.
And in the presence of. That we are now.
Stay on for better or for worse. Joy or for worse.
Joy or for worse.
Sickness and health.
Love and cherish.
Thank you.
And may together.
Joy, life's pleasures.
Life's pleasures. And bear life's burdens.
As long as our lives.
As long as our lives endure.
Let it be faithful to my death.
My pledge to be faithful to my death.
And ever make the service.
Pledge.
Circle, ladies and gentlemen, has been a symbol of eternity from earliest recorded human history. Therefore, these rings are symbolic of boundless and endless love. The rings are constructed of an imperishable metal, thus they speak of the imperishable and enduring quality of the love which they represent. They should be given, received, and borne with these concepts in mind. And as you place this ring, Marie's finger and repeat after me.
That was
Marie, I give you this ring.
Marie, I give you this ring.
As a pledge.
And shelter the ground.
As a pledge.
Of constant faith and abiding love.
Constant faith and abiding love.
You place the ring. Well done.
Done.
Maria,
which one?
Place. Help you with it. Yeah, I give you this ring.
And I give you this ring.
As a pledge. Constant faith and abiding love.
Constant faith and abiding love.
Place the ring. And may these rings always be a symbol of your lifelong union as husband and wife, a sign of your love and loyalty to each other. As a reminder. Ladies and gentlemen, for as much as Marie and y'all have consented together in marriage, have witnessed the same before God, families, and friends, and have given and pledged their faithfulness each to the other, and have declared the same by giving and receiving these rings and by joining hands, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the state of California, I do now pronounce you husband and wife.
Mazel tov!
Yeah! I'd like you now to place your ring hands together. You take her ring hand. Now each look at each other's hands as I speak. For the hand which you offer to the other is an extension of yourself, just as the warmth that you talk about to each other. Be sensitive to its pulse. Try to understand this forward with just as you do. Marie, any union of your lives dispel fear and loneliness, enlarge love and understanding, bring peace, mutual support, love, bring friendship, as you journey through life. May now kiss your bride.
Hey, get a room.
We will. That's what I mean, I know.
Yeah, hold on to it.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Cordona.
And you'll hold the dress up for the girl.